Yo, what's the deal, good people? It's your boy Eric Taylor, Big E Astrology. Back. Continuing my Juno house series, today I will be explaining and breaking down for you Juno in the Tres, third house. Yeah, Juno in the third house. So we'll break down Juno. We'll also break down the third house. Excuse me. So you understand this placement in astrology. Juno is the asteroid for long-term relationships, commitment, oh my voice, and marriage. Okay? Juno is Jupiter's wife in Greek mythology. So, you know, if I'm doing a love chart reading for you, Juno, fifth, seventh house, Venus, Jupiter, these are the placements that I would assess and interpret for you to break down to give you a mini relationship chart. So that's Juno. It's got a little Libra, Scorpio feel to it, but not that serious connection and love. And I know not everybody believes in marriage, you know, I'm 15 years in, but you know, I know everyone's got their thoughts and their own, you know, beliefs. And let's get to the third house in the natal birth chart. So the third house is about your writing, your learning, your communications. Uh-huh. The third house is elementary school. We're talking about our siblings, cousins, neighbors, and actually the younger siblings. It's also social media, your skills, your self-efforts, your athletic ability. It's also vehicles in the local community, 50 miles or closer to home. All right? Your actual neighborhood, said the social media. You could see sometimes competition here. And this also becomes the adult relationship with your mother. Very important. All right? So when you have Juno, the asteroid for love, in your third house? Okay. Number one, would you comment down below? Please like, share, and subscribe, but comment down below what sign it is in this third house. And that's gonna flavor the story, the sign. The third house is the theme of this love in terms of this could literally be a neighbor that you grew up with or someone even as an adult, let's say age 26 or 38, right, that you live close to, or they're within your proximity in your neighborhood. Or maybe you meet them when you're driving, or you meet your Uber driver, because this is vehicles and transportation. Maybe you meet them on the one train or on the A train, right? Maybe you meet them on the MARTA, or, you know, maybe you're meeting them just like running around down in DC and Northwest, Southeast. These are just examples. Your cousin or your sibling could connect you with this person that you may potentially marry, right? Now, literally, it could be someone you knew from grade school, and then they just come back in your life. You go to a high school reunion, right? Or someone that you connect with over Facebook, social media, that you went to, you know, fourth grade with, right? It can really be someone that you meet going on a jog in your community, in your neighborhood, right? This can be someone that you meet at work, that you're, you know, you meet over Zoom, or you're emailing or texting back and forth, and you've got a group project, and then you meet them and you're like, wow, you know, this is the one for me. Okay? So if let's say Sagittarius was here, maybe you meet them at your local church, right? Or maybe you meet them when you're going to the grocery market, if it's Sag or Taurus, farmer's market, all right? Taurus, maybe you can meet them at the bank, right? Maybe they're your banker. Gemini could be coworkers, a fellow school teacher, okay? Virgo, you know, or Scorpio could meet them at a doctor's office or at the gym. There's a whole, you know, bunch of different things. The Libra could just be someone, you know, you're meeting socially when you're out communicating with friends, a friend of a friend, a friend of the cousin, the sibling, the friend, the cousin, the neighbor. You're like, how did that? Yeah, it could just be in a social event. But I'll tell you this, you have Juno in the third house, you need mental stimulation. You need someone that likes to kind of move about and go hang out here, but you need communication in the relationship. It won't work for you, right? If you're trying to marry someone that's stoic and doesn't speak and doesn't communicate and always wants to be, you know, in home and they're not social at all, they're a homebody, you got Juno in the third house, that person's not for you. I don't care what other alignments you have in your chart. I'm serious, okay? Now you wanna look in depth. A synergy compatibility chart is very important. You know, you hit me up, we can book that. It's my only still partially written report with videos, and it's breaking down you and your significant other or partner or whoever your other person is, and letting you know how this relationship can play out, how the planets are communicating with one another. Because we can misinterpret and not understand each other and do things subconsciously that are hurting our partner, not even mean to or intend to. And I can see that in the synastry chart, and then you get that information and knowledge, that revelation, and then you can stop it. And then the relationship could be more than successful. It could be forever, ever, forever, ever. Okay? It's $180, synastry compatibility chart. It's amazing, really worth it, okay? I think that's the new price. But in general, you know, maybe it's 179. All right. So yeah, it's 179. I'm switching my prices, you know. Big Astrology is making moves, all right? But also, remember, you can meet them on the bus and a cab. Right? Walking down the street. This can be someone that, you know, loves, you know, sports. You meet them at a sports bar. Okay? Maybe you meet this amazing girl that's in, like, your cousin's or brother's fantasy football league, and she likes fantasy football, and she's, like, she's the only girl in the league or something. You know what I mean? Like, things like that could happen. That could happen in the fifth house, too, but definitely in the third house. But understand this, because it's also the adult relationship with your mother could literally introduce you, just like in a fourth house, but your mom, you know, let's say you're older, and your mother could be the one that says, you know, my friend Susan, she's got this great son, and I want you to go out on a date with him. Okay, Jessica? Okay, you know, Cynthia? I want you to go meet Matthew. He's a great guy. Susan's son. And you know what I mean? So it can be those type of situations. Maybe you're like, you know, 37, 38, you're 40, you're like, bad relationships, you never got married. And then your mother, let's say 38, right? Third house is 38 years old, annual perfection technique. And you meet this person and it's the love of your life. The communication is on point, all this stuff. You know what I mean? That's what Juno in the third house can play out as. So I hope you get it, hope you got it, I hope it's good. And Juno is really an important placement, you know? And remember, whatever sign it is, it can be the sun, the moon, the rising. They could even have like a stellium, which is three planets or more. It could be like Mercury, Venus, Jupiter in Capricorn in the third house, right? Or moon, Uranus, Neptune in Pisces in the third house. You know what I mean? Or Scorpio, Mars, Pluto, and Saturn. I'm just giving you random examples. The stellium is three planets or more. But in general, it would be a sun, moon, or rising of the sign that energetically may be the spiritual connection that is actually right for you. Right? My Juno's in Taurus. My wife is a Taurus rising, just to give you an example. See how that worked? Didn't know that when I married her. It's only God. All right, you guys. So hit me up. Big E Astrology. B-I-G-E Astrology. It's the nickname, you know what I'm saying? Big E Astrology. astrologyandmagic@gmail.com. You want to order a book, a birth chart, hit me up. You want to come to Coffee Talk, you want to check out some of my other services, just reach out to me, all right? I'm an open book, love to talk to you guys, and I love to see you at my monthly meetings. So I hope I see you August 19, 2023, Saturday, 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific over Zoom. For 2 hours, $20, I'll be teaching a lesson on Virgo season. Virgo season. It's on August 23rd. When the sun goes into Virgo and Mercury goes retrograde in Virgo. So that's the chart we'll be looking at. Then, on August 19th, we will look at two Coffee Talk members' birth charts and interpret them as a group, not just me, all of us, because this is how you learn astrology, we have fun, and then we get the instant feedback of our analysis. And it's magical, it's beautiful. Like, the Coffee Talk people love it. Everyone's interpreting. It's so informative, but it's amazing the insight and knowledge you get when someone can give you the instant feedback to how their life is, how it was, how it's going to be. Because you can learn all that through astrology, the map of your life. That's why I'm unlocking this ancient wisdom for you called astrology. Got it? All right, Juno in the third house. Peace. Eric Taylor, Biggie Astrology.